All new tonight, a controversial new treatment for depression. The FDA approved the antidepressant this week, and it's a nasal spray that contains a drug similar to ketamine.
Now, there are some risks associated with the new drug, and tonight, Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Jennifer Lee is telling us more about the groundbreaking research that actually happened right here in Hartford.
It's a nasal spray that's shown to deliver rapid results in treating depression in people who have proven to be resistant to current antidepressants on the market.
But we see results within days and most a few weeks.
But the new treatment called S-ketamine can be mind-altering. It's similar to ketamine, the club drug called Special K.
It is very self-limited. It within an hour, 1.5 hours maximum, they are completely back to baseline.
Dr. Mirela Lotus is directly involved in researching this new antidepressant method. Her team at the Institute of Living sees firsthand the benefits of the drug for patients.
Some of these patients that we have worked closely and intimately with and we have helped to feel better throughout the years are part of the data that has been used by FDA to obtain approval.
The FDA approved the controversial drug this week and says risks include sedation, difficulty with attention, judgment, and thinking, abuse and misuse, suicidal thoughts and behaviors. To mitigate the risks and prevent abuse, the drug can only be used in doctor's offices that are approved, and patients are evaluated for at least 2 hours after using the drug.
Health officials and people are hopeful that S-ketamine will help millions of Americans who are suffering from depression who haven't found other methods of treatment that worked before.
I imagine if it can help people, if people who suffer from depression would be open to trying it. I have friends who do suffer from depression, and if there's anything that can help them.
Doctors say current antidepressants boost juices in the brain like serotonin, but S-ketamine is unique.
It seems to be also involved in what we call synaptic plasticity, so in the brain, just making new connections and changing previous connections, which that is a very novel mechanism.
Dr. Lotus is now researching the drug's effect on children and adolescents suffering from depression and, in extreme cases, suicidal thoughts. In Hartford, Jennifer Lee, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.